Digitalization has completely revolutionized the way once animation was done. It has helped in speeding the animation process and even added more creative possibilities. Budget and time has always been a crucial deciding factor for animation. For limited animation, it is even more crucial, and the invention of TV has challenged the animators even more to create animation in lesser time with low budget. Let's have a look at how the animation can be minimized for limited animation. The character designs, including BG and other props for the limited animation, are very simplified and stylistic rather than being very realistic. Mostly, they're symmetrical to make the drawing easier and faster. Each part of the character that is to be animated is drawn in different layers. These parts are then archived and saved in a library, which are later swapped according to the requirement of the animation, whereas the static or non-animated part remains as it is. This process makes it easier for the animators to use the same parts of the character repeatedly for different frames according to the requirement. By this, one does not have to keep drawing the same part or static images again and again for every frame. Few of the prominent features of limited animations are loop animations and pan animation. For instance, in a walk or a run animation, moving the character from one end to the other would have taken a lot of frames or drawings, which consumes more time. But if one complete walk or a run cycle is drawn and is kept in loop, whereas the background is in pan, it creates an illusion of the character moving from one end to the other. And this can be achieved in fewer drawings in much lesser time. Motion tween is a feature in most of the animating software that helps doing simple object animations. One can create a motion tween which will automatically move the object from the beginning location to the end location. Here, the animator does not have to draw the in-betweens, but only has to drag the object from the starting to the end point. Rest of the in-betweens are calculated by the computer and generated, which animators do not have to draw. Smear was pioneered by Chuck Jones with his film The Drover Boys. It was one of many ways of cutting down drawings in animation. Smears in animations are frames between two keyframes, which holds a whoop or an elongated shape to describe or convey an exaggerated motion. One can create dramatic and fast motion using it in just few frames. Another is multiple animation, where a single frame contains three or more drawings of the same part describing the motion. Camera angles and cutscenes are other tricks to cut down the animation. Also, music, voices and effects play a greater role in cutting down the animation. But one has to keep in mind that the animation being limited should still convey the story clearly. Other than the above ways, there can be many more ways to cut down the animation. Thank you for watching.